gentlemen, thank you for your time this evening. I'm sure you're all anxious to hear about the progress we're making in the search for the tomb of King Hale the Amon Ray Chunk. So I'll get straight to the point. We found it. Just 6 days ago, behind the east wall.
East wall?
We checked.
Now, I'm sure you've all heard the legends about the supposed power that the king possessed. It's said that the king received his powers from a ring he wore. He received the ring from a messenger who fell from the heavens. The messenger was badly hurt, and before he died, he revealed the powers of the ring to the king in the hopes that the king would fulfill his mission for him. Now, no one knows exactly what the king was told by the messenger, but it is said that if the king were to wear this ring and chant a specific phrase, he could open a portal through time. And it is through this portal that the king brought power and wealth to his kingdom, or so the legend goes. We may scoff at this now, but people of the past did believe many odd and, we might say, ridiculous things. But that's besides the point. The point is that when we unearthed the coffin of King Hale the Amon Ray Chunk, we found on the ring finger of that right hand the object we've been searching for all these years, in all the legends, in the scrolls, and the history books. And gentlemen, it is with great pleasure I present to you now the ring of King Hale the Amon Ray Chunk. It wasn't easy getting this ring. The Egyptian government wants it back as soon as we're done with our research. That ring is worth easily $50 million, and it doesn't take geniuses like ourselves to realize that this may attract some unwanted attention.
Hey, Bud, I thought you told us smoking was bad for our health.
I did. This is bubblegum. Okay, boys, let's go.
Now, I will be heading up the research on this ring. I will need some additional support. I assume I can count on each and every one of you to contribute equally?
Certainly, yes.
Very good.
Yes.
Okay, boys, the party's over.
That's right, keep your hands up.
Now then, there is a certain ring I want. Where is it?
Ring? What ring? You must have the wrong room. You want room 211 down the hall.
Boys, we have been watching you. Now then, I want that ring. No ring, he dies.
Listen, we don't know what you're talking about. What ring?
Yeah, what's this for, huh?
That's a present for my wife. It's a pincushion. You gonna kill us for that?
Okay, we can deal with this. Paco? Okay. Let's beat the ring out of him.
Ha ha ha!
Worthless. Made about a million of these in 85. Dispensed them out of gumball machines. Tell you what, got a little girl that might like this. I can give you a book price for it. Say, 50 cents?
Well, nothing yet, sir.
What?
Well, keep looking!
We have been. We've searched all night. Up on the rooftops, in the gutters, down in the alleys, under every box, in dumpsters. Fritz here even searched the cat.
Okay. We saw him throw the ring, but we couldn't find it. So we've got a little problem here. Obviously, somebody got to the ring before we did. So let's check around with the people on the streets. Ask the owners of businesses. They might have seen something. Won't be too long before somebody realizes they've got the biggest ring in history.
So, you're looking for something nice for your girlfriend?
Well, she's not actually my... Well, yes. Yes, I am.
What's the occasion?
You see, she's in this play. Here. Tomorrow night's opening night, and I want to express my love to her with an opening night gift. You see, she plays the lead princess.
How wonderful.
It's real short, though, only a one act. But she still shines through. You should go see it.
Sounds like a great play. And to make it extra special for your girlfriend. It's a one-of-a-kind ring. Handmade in Germany by the late Schermenhofer. A perfect gift for the leading lady.
How much?
Well, I hate to part with this, but $10?
Great, I'll take it.
All right, you have a good one now. Oh, excuse me, sorry.
Can I help you, fellas?
Yeah, we're looking for something. A ring. You see, my grandma was taking a nice stroll down the street when this guy walks up to her and says, stick him up. And then he robs her, taking all her money and her wedding ring. Given to her by dear old grandpa over 50 years ago. There was a fire. They lost everything. Grandpa didn't make it. That ring was the last memory she had of him.
Was this a silver ring with little patches of stone on it and some strange handwriting?
You have it?
No, I sold it.
To who? Could you tell me who he was?
Well, no, I'm sorry, pal. Hey, yeah. He said he was going to give it to his girlfriend, who plays the leading princess in this play. It opens tomorrow night. Maybe you could go there and convince him to give you back the ring at your grandma's.
Hi.
Kirsten, do you think I was wrong to slap Steve?
Well, he did surprise me a little. But he deserved it.
Holy chunk, I met him yesterday and I introduced myself. He said, hi, my name's Steve. Will you marry me? I thought he was kidding.
Well, hey, if it isn't my favorite actress.
Look, Steve, you shouldn't be in here, and I don't have time to talk. We go on in a few minutes.
Oh, come on. I just wanted to give you an opening night gift. No harm in that.
No, really, Steve.
No need to thank me. Your sparkling eyes have already done that. Now, let's see how it looks on you.
Steve, I just don't...
Oh, it looks wonderful. And it'll look great tonight at dinner.
What?
I've rented a limo. I'll pick you up outside after the show.
But I don't have to...
I better go get me a seat before they're all taken. And good luck tonight, my little princess.
He thinks for 1 minute that I'm going to go out to dinner with him? Ugh. What's the matter? Can't you get it off? I don't know. It's stuck. Hang on. Let me see if I can find some Vaseline.
Okay, everybody, it's showtime. Places.
No time. I guess I'll just have to wear it. How do I look? You look great. How do I look? Like a real princess. Come on, let's go knock them dead.
May I sit here? You know, I was watching them practicing the play a little earlier, and they're phenomenal. Especially the girl that plays the lead princess. I happen to know her personally. She's a good friend of mine. In fact, I've even asked her...
This it?
Yeah, this is the place, boss.
Okay, then. You know the plan. Put the guns away and let's go.
Excuse me. The show has already started and I can't allow anyone in.
Oh, is that so?
Yes, it is.
Because me and the boys were really looking forward to seeing the show tonight.
Well, I'm sorry. You'll just have to come back another time. We have other shows playing throughout the week. And I'm sure if you come back then...
That would work, but... Yeah, no. I really hate the wait. Boys, get rid of them.
You will duel with me!
All right, then. A duel it is. I'm gone!
But I will not release my spell.
No! No! Release it! Release the spell!
Oh, princess! I have failed you! What will I do? Princess, speak to me.
Princess?
Didn't work, but I didn't want him to know that.
Oh, princess!
A ring. Where, boss? Girl princess.
Mordir is destroyed, my daughter is saved, and we have found her husband, loyal and brave. Oh, this is truly a day for celebration.
Long live the king!
Long live the king! Hooray!
The rest of us will be waiting in the limo. Bring her out, throw her in the back.
Okay, boss.
Oh, and boy, keep it clean.
You are great! How are you?
Hey, great job tonight, everybody. The audience loved you. Heck, I loved you. Hey, don't bother to change. We're heading back to my place for an in-costume celebration. I've got some cake, some cookies, and some punch, so it should be pretty fun. All right, I'll see you guys there.
Oh, that sounds like fun. Yeah, at least like to get some of this makeup off first and grab a few things. About a pound of stage makeup.
Yeah. Come on. Let's go. I don't want to be late.
Stuff, you know that?
I'm sorry, but people who aren't involved in productions aren't really allowed on
them. What the?
Okay, I'm ready to go. Just as soon as I find my purse. Have you seen it? To save us some cake.
Yeah.
This is so much fun!
I know, I'm so excited. Just think, we still have four more shows to do.
Oh! Hey, whose car should take the party?
Let's just take mine.
All right.
Let's just walk.
Yeah.
That's her. Who's Paco and Careful?
Careful. Oh, get up. Oh, you're out.
Oh, no. What? See the limo? Remember, Steve thinks he's taking me out to dinner.
Something's wrong. They must know something's up.
Come on, this way. You may not see it.
They're getting away! Louie, step on!
Job tonight with the play, and me and the boys just wanted to congratulate you. So, congratulations.
Congratulations.
Well, thank you. Thanks.
Now that we've gotten that out of the way, boys, kill him.
What? You can't do that. We're girls.
Oh,
closes. Come on, boys, snap out of it. Come on. About the ring is true. She must have said something that activated the time portal.
Join yourselves.
Jill, what's going on?
I don't know. I don't know.
Hold my cock!
Yes, sir!
Hold my cock!
Have a mushroom.
We're not downtown no more, is we, boss? It's amazing. The ring doesn't just take you through time, but across lands, too. Looks to me like we're somewhere in Europe, during the Middle Ages.
Where's the girls?
I don't know, but they gotta be somewhere in this vicinity. So keep your eyes peeled.
What is this? Would you look at this? Maggots wriggling from the woods!
All hail the King's Army!
It's the King's Army.
I, Baron von Felsen, am Captain of the Guard.
I don't care who the devil you are. What is this scrawny bunch doing here?
We seek the king's two beautiful daughters, Helga and Brunhilde, for they have been kidnapped.
We have traveled a great distance in search of them. Continue your search elsewhere. We don't have your Helga and Brunhilde.
I never said you did, but nonetheless, I will search your camp anyway.
Does it look like we have any princesses around here?
Excuse me.
Where'd they come from?
Could someone please tell us what's going on around here?
It's the princess, liar, kidnapper!
We don't want to get involved in this mess.
I've saved you!
Princesses?
Weird things.
We're stuck here, aren't we? We're stuck in the medieval period for the rest of our lives.
Does anybody know what time it is?
Does it really matter?
Okay, boys. There's a way out of everything. If we just think through this hard enough, we can free ourselves and go after the girls. And more importantly, the ring.
Do you really think we'll be able to find them?
Do I? Why? What is it that I always tell you, boys? When you're after something and you go after with everything you've got, you're gonna get it. If there's anything that can stop you, not a thing.
Not even them, boss?
No, not even.
Well, well, well. What is it that we've caught today?
Where are they? Beggars?
Oh, that is just funny.
They're wizards!
Yeah, that's right. We're wizards. And if you don't let us down, we'll turn you into frogs or something.
If you're really wizards, then how come you didn't teleport yourselves out of our trap?
Because we was waiting to see who was responsible for this so we could kill them.
Hey, Kevin. Look at these.
Hey, you be careful with those.
You know what I think? I think the reason why these wizards can't do their magic is because they need these.
What are they?
They're magic wands or staffs or something of the sort. I'm right, aren't I?
I'm warning you.
Cut them down. We'll take them back to camp. I'm sure we can find a few good uses for wizards.
I'm really hungry.
I am too. But I don't see anything that looks edible, or at least anything I'd like to eat.
Well, if we get to the point of starvation, we could always eat grass. I read you could do that.
Grass? There's gotta be berries or something around here.
Chill! Look at that!
Do you think somebody lives here? I sure hope so. They might even have some food.
looking for trouble, I have to warn you. This place is heavily guarded by over 100 skilled fighters waiting to attack at my command, so you'd better...
Well, I'll be.
Hello there.
You wouldn't happen to be hungry, would you?
Thank you.
Thanks.
I hope you like it.
It looks delicious.
Oh, thank you. It's a mixture that I created myself. I like to experiment with the food that I eat to give it a little variety. This is my favorite.
This is really good. What's in it?
Oh, mostly leaves and berries that I collected from the forest. But what gives it its exceptional flavor are the fly guts and the beetle blood. Oh, no, I'm only joking.
For all we knew, you could have been telling the truth. So where's everyone else?
Who else do you mean?
Oh, your soldiers or fighters or whoever you said guarded this place.
Oh, they don't really exist. That's just something that I say when I think I might be getting unwelcome visitors, like thieves. This forest is simply crawling with bands of them. I haven't had any serious trouble with anyone yet, but if I do, I am well prepared to deal with them. Say, if you two need a place to stay for a while, you're more than welcome to stay here.
Oh, really? But that would be great. Thanks a lot. We'll only need to stay here till we can find our way back home.
Home? You want to go home?
Well, yes. Why not?
Oh, come now. You don't have to pretend with me. I know who you are.
You do? He does?
Oh, the king thinks you've been kidnapped. But I know the truth, and most everyone does. You ran away because he was going to force you to marry those two ugly and arrogant princes from Wales. Oh, I can't blame you for running away from a marriage that was made for the sole purpose of territory.
Whoa. Hold on a second. Who do you think that we are?
You're the king's two youngest daughters. However, I must admit that you are far more attractive than the stories have told.
But we're not the king's daughters.
Oh, come now. If you want to pass yourselves off as peasants, then you should be wearing peasants' clothing. Not those.
But we're wearing these because we were in a play, and these were our costumes. Jill, should we tell them about who we are and everything?
Well, yes, do tell.
But if we tell you, you'll either think that we're crazy or that we're lying.
No. I can see that you are sincere. I'll believe you.
Well, okay. We're from the future.
I think I heard about these guys. Didn't they use their evil magic to destroy the town of Akmar?
Yeah. I suppose there must be some kind of reward out for the capture. Well, we'll see around camp tonight.
You suppose we get to kill him?
Well, we'll see.
What are we gonna do, boss?
Don't worry, boys. We can figure a way out of this. Really, we can deal with this.
Work for us.
Hey, get away from my stuff. Come on.
Be quiet.
What's up the ceiling?
You guys,
is that the stuff that we stole from them?
Yeah, but I have no idea what it is.
No, you quit that.
Look at this.
It's got a lot of weird writing on it. Probably spells or something of the sort.
Well, I can't read.
Neither can I.
Who's that guy?
He's probably their chief wizard. He's probably the one that wrote all these spells.
Ah, burn their filthy magic.
What's the matter? Did those mean a lot to you?
That was all of our money.
Don't worry, boys. As soon as we get out of here and get the ring, we'll have more money than we could possibly imagine.
We're gonna sell it?
No. We're gonna use the ring to travel to different time periods and gather valuables. Even something that's worthless now could be worth a fortune in our time.
We don't even know what words to say to make the ring work.
So we'll ask the girls. And if they don't tell us, we'll torture them until they do.
So how do we get out of this?
We wait till the time is right.
You say that you are not princesses. I would have to disagree. Sleep well tonight.
Sleep. We gotta wiggle our way out of these ropes. Wake up. We gotta go find those girls. And Fritz, we need to know what the word is that opens the portal. So don't kill them. Let's go.
Did you sleep well?
Yes.
Oh, thanks.
Thank you.
Okay. We
We followed their footprints to this place, and they stuck. So, how much do you want to bet that we found our girls?
Are these the fellows you were talking about?
Huh? Who's out there?
Okay, Goyles, we know you're in there, so come on out, and we won't hurt you.
Don't worry, I'll take care of them.
What are you beggars doing on my land? Pardon me, but we don't want anything to do with you. We just want the girls.
What girls are you talking about? I live alone. I wouldn't come any closer if I were you. This place is heavily guarded, with over 100 skilled fighters who are all ready to attack at my command.
I thought you just said you lived alone. Get it?
All right, I warned you. All men to their battle stations. Attack! Larry! Move your men out back into position! What was that?
It's a gunshot!
A weapon of the future?
Let's go.
Let that force go into the basement. There's an outside exit. Go hide in the forest.
What about you?
Don't worry about me. I've still got a few tricks left. Go.
We didn't go home.
Oh, no. Where are we now?
Doesn't look like those guys followed us through this time. What did we do to make them want to kill us so badly?
Nothing's been making sense lately. I don't know what we should do now.
Jill, look it over there. A little town. Maybe we should go there.
Well, yeah. Better than standing around here. I just hope we don't run into any more trouble.
Me too.
Boys, we run into. You ladies ain't from around these parts, are you?
Look, boys, it's been nice chatting with you, but we don't have time for these little games, so we'll catch you later.
Whoa, where do you girls think you're going? You wasn't planning on leaving us now, was you?
What do you say, boys? These girls are good dancers to you? Let's find out.
Come on. Now that is really old. Okay?
Pretty good, don't they?
Some of the finest dancing I ever seen.
Looks like we got ourselves a Mexican standoff. Why don't we just pull our horns in here and talk about it a while? You know, I might be able to use some fellas like you in my outfit. You boys ever robbed a bank?
Town dressed like that.
Well, we didn't know that.
Where are you girls from?
We're from the place far away, and we're trying to get back, but we don't know how.
Travel problems, eh? I know a man here in town who can help you with that. Old Dusty down at the saloon. He helps a lot of people who lose their way. But for now, let's get you into some other clothes. Here, try these on.
Oh.
Now then, I'll be right back. If you two ladies need anything, I'll be more than happy to help you out.
Thanks.
Thank you.
I wonder what year this is.
Looks like we landed in the Wild West. So, back then.
And now we're stuck here until the time passage opens up again.
You know, I just realized something. The time passage seems to open up whenever we're in danger.
Maybe that's why it opens.
Maybe. I don't know. But in the meantime, we better try and fit in here the best we can.
Yeah, I'm gonna change dresses.
All right. You know, why do we have to wear dresses anyways?
Well, what do you mean?
Well, why can't we wear Western clothes? You know, like cowboy boots and jeans and an old flannel shirt and a hat. I mean, that's what I wear when I go out riding on the ranch.
Don't be silly, Jill. Girls didn't wear that in this time.
Uh-huh. Calamity Jane did.
Calamity Jane? But she was rough and tough. And had a reputation.
These people
people don't know who I am. I could just still... Remember, we're trying to fit in, not stick out.
So it turns out we can use each other's services. You help my boys rob the bank with them fancy shooting irons you're carrying, and I'll help you snatch them two gals you're looking for.
Yeah, but you think you can get them?
Well, everybody knows that Wild-Eyed Cody is the best darn women snatcher in the whole territory. So, that ourselves a deal?
Well, Jill, what do you think? Is it me?
Kirsten, lighten up. As long as we're here, we might as well make the best of it.
All right, you girls done changing? We can go over and see. Mercy me, girl. What are you doing wearing those clothes?
So you're cousins, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Well, that's mighty fascinating.
Everyone, I'd like you to meet two new ladies in town, Kirsten Rose and Calamity Jill.
Howdy, boys.
Jill here is cousin to Calamity Jane.
Well, howdy.
This here's Dusty.
Hi, ladies. Can I help you with something?
He'll take care of all your travel problems.
Oh, well, thank you. Well, we'll see.
So, what can I do for you ladies?
Are we tearing this town apart looking for them?
Don't worry, girls. Hang tight.
Maybe you can help me. Where's the newcomers?
Much obliged.
Sheriff, hurry! Come on! Come on, Sheriff!
Sheriff! Where are they? I'm ordering you, Cody. You got no business here. You get out of my place or I'll... Why, you dirty...
Why, you...
Hold on, Deputy. Where's the trouble?
Hey, Cabot.
Hey, there's the sheriff. Where do you
think you're going, little lady? I got one. Whoa. What do we got
Where do you want to take these girls? That wagon there will do just fine. You get the horses, I'll meet you out of town.
Come on.
Get this wagon moving, driver, now!
Chase after wild-eyed Cody, that'd be suicide.
That's the toughest woman I ever seen.
She'll never make it.
The base. We've planted scanner 22 in sector C-15. Is there anything showing up on radar yet?
That's a negative. No sign of the enemy base. Hey,
Wait, you're breaking up. How did you two...
What? What is it?
She's wearing the time distorter.
The what? She is. What? You mean this ring? Oh, a guy gave this to me. Is it yours? You can have it if you want. Here, you can have it back.
You can't take it off. It's attached to your life force.
My what?
You don't know what this is, do you?
A ring?
Task Force 1 to base.
Blake, what happened out there?
I'll tell you about it in a little bit. We're coming in. Get the time distorter equipment ready.
The distorter equipment? Blake, is Dr. Baylor back?
Not exactly. Just wait, we'll be in a minute.
Sounds like good news to me. Will do. Base out.
What about those guys?
You two, looking for something?
Yeah, we're looking to see if we were followed this time.
Followed?
Yeah, these guys and suits keep following us through time. We keep thinking we've lost them, but they always...
Whoa, you've been traveling through time? Well, then you know about the time distorter. Did Dr. Baylor give it to you?
Who? We don't know what's been going on. All we know is that this weird time passage keeps opening up every time we're in danger.
So you don't know about the time distorter? Come with us to our base. We've got a lot to talk about.
Those two look familiar. Haven't I seen them before?
You know, I was thinking the same thing.
All right, boys. We've messed this up every time now. So, let's not do it again.
So what's the plan, boss?
I don't have one.
We just need to wait till the time's right.
So they don't know how the time distorter works?
Apparently not.
And yet they've been traveling through time.
My guess is that they've been saying the code word that activates the time distorter by accident. I don't know what this talk is of somebody chasing them. They seem to be pretty confused about the whole situation.
We got the time distorter back. It gives us another chance.
It doesn't make sense. They shouldn't be here. If anything happens to them, it could change the entire...
How do they fit? You should be much more comfortable around here.
I'd like to ask you a few questions.
Yeah, I have a few questions myself. Like, what year is this, and what is this whole operation going on here?
Well, the year is 2085. We're a special forces unit sent by the government to investigate possible terrorist activity in this area. Well, we found it. The leader of the terrorist group is called Kavorek.
Possibly the most twisted, evil man ever to live.
Kavorek and his men have set up a missile site somewhere around here and plan on launching a nuclear attack at strategic points around the Earth's crust.
This would decimate two-thirds of the world's population and leave the rest of the Earth in shambles, ready for Kavorek to take over as leader.
Well, can't you stop him?
We've run into more problems than we expected. 3 weeks ago, we arrived in the area. With us was Dr. Baylor, the inventor of the time distorter. Dr. Baylor was really the only one that knew anything about it because it was still experimental. We were hoping that if we were unable to stop Kavorek here, we could use it to take us back through time to stop him any way we could.
Like preventing him from being born.
That was the plan, but Kavorek had a surprise for us. The day we arrived, he set up an electronic field over the entire area. As far as we can tell, about a 20-mile radius. No one gets in, no one gets out. The shield is so powerful that it's cut off all our communication with the outside world, and it's even changed the temperature. Then he pinpointed us down and attacked. That's the last we ever saw of him.
And then we were going through some old files of ours and found these.
What are they?
Have you ever heard the legend of King Haole Amon Rechunk?
Uh-uh.
Well, the story goes that an angel fell from the heavens and gave the king a magical ring.
Now, our guess is that this angel was Dr. Baylor, and the ring was the time distorter, and he gave it to the king just before he died.
He'd gone through time, but didn't succeed in changing it. We're here, Kavorek's here, and the whole planet is still under the threat of his missile attack. After Kavorek's men hit our camp, we relocated here. It's not much of a headquarters, but it'll do. We managed to salvage most of the equipment, and now we're preparing for our attack on his missile site.
Which is why we were setting up scanners. So far, we haven't been able to find it.
And if we're gonna stop him, we need to find it soon.
But we do have another option, the time distorter.
And that's what this is?
When Dr. Baylor left, there were 40 charges on the ring. Each time a portal was opened, it would use a charge. He designed the ring so that every fourth charge would take you back to your point of origin.
Oh, Jill! We've gone through the time passage 3 times. That means the next time we get to go home.
I'd like to check to see how many charges are left on the time distorter. Follow me. Stick your hand in here. There's only one charge left, and Dr. Baylor is the only one who knows how to recharge the time distorter.
And the next time the portal opens, it's going back to their time, and that's too early to stop it.
Well, we can forget about using the time distorter. Now we're going to have to concentrate our efforts on finding that missile base before he launches those missiles.
So what should we do?
Well, you can go ahead and use the time distorter to go back home.
Well, we don't know how it works.
Well, that's right, you don't know the code word. You've been using it on accident. I don't know how. Say Raylab, the doctor's last name backwards.
Raylab?
It doesn't work. The doctor must have changed the code when he went back through time.
So now what are we gonna do?
Well, sit down and try and figure out everything you've said in the past few days and try and figure out what you said to activate the time distorter. Blake, you need to go out on perimeters. Why don't you go with him, why don't you stay here with me, and we'll mull this over.
Do you think that you'll find the missile base soon?
I sure hope so. The more of these scanners that we set up, the better our chances get. Task Force 1 to base. I just set the scanner.
How do things look?
Looks good. Scanners are checking out.
There it is! We found it! We found it! Got it!
What? What's wrong?
Down! Down!
Blake!
Get your men out of there! Blake! Blake!
What's going on?
This isn't gonna be easy.
That's it. Take the men around the north slope. Wait for my signal. Go with him. Ready? Now you stay back. Hudson, ready?
Gonna grab some of those fancy guns and follow them in there.
Boss?
Hey, do you want the girls to get away? Come on!
They think they can stop me? Start the missile launch! Move it! Move it!
Okay, girls. It's been swell chasing through time with you and all, but I'm afraid you have lost. We have won the ring. Now.
Listen, you guys. This place is going to go up in about 2 minutes.
We got to get out of here.
Look, we believe you completely. Now, no more tricks. The ring.
Yes, thank you, sir. Briggs out.
Well, they're on their way. Soon we'll be going home, us few who are left. Which just leaves you two. I'm sure you're anxious to get back home to your time.
Mm-hmm. But we don't know the code word that activates this thing.
You can't remember what you said.
Did you say, like, look out, or let's run, or... Look out! Let's run! Here they come! Holy chunk, I just can't remember.
That's it. Holy chunk. The first and last part of the king's name.
Well, I guess this is goodbye. Thanks for all your help.
Yeah. Hurry. That's your way home.
Looking all over town for you. Come on, we're late for dinner. What? You don't want to go to dinner with me, huh? What's her name could come too, as long as she pays for herself. Come on, I rent a little limo. I thought you'd like it. Jill? Listen, Jill, you are throwing away one grand opportunity.
Skin, burn them back to the stone.